welcome to this edition of Trump's Ask the Expert. My name is Travis Stempky, and I am a laser application engineer here in the Trump Laser Technology Center in Plymouth, Michigan. Today's Ask the Expert topic is on the benefits of green lasers. Trump offers two welding solutions. The TrueDisc Pulse 221 and 421 are pulse disc lasers, and the TrueDisc 1020 is a continuous disc laser. The benefits of the green wavelength can be seen in the graph. As you can see, with the infrared, the absorption is around 5%, but when you shift over to the green, it increases to 40%. The benefit of the green laser comes in the absorption of copper at various temperatures. The graph on the far left shows, at room temperature, the absorption of the light into the copper. The near infrared is around 5%, while when it shifts to the green, it's around 40%. As the heat increases in the copper, the absorption increases in the infrared, but then when it becomes molten, it jumps up another 5%. The second graph shows how the absorption increases as the temperature increases. The red line signifies when the material becomes molten, and then the absorption jumps another 5%. The top on the graph shows the green wavelength absorption as the temperature changes. When it becomes molten, there isn't nearly as much of a jump, and therefore you have a much stable process. Videos in the right are going to show the difference between infrared and green wavelengths when it comes to heat conduction welding. As can be seen in the video, the weld position varies in infrared welding, where with the green wavelength, the start position is very similar and the weld pool is very consistent. The next set of videos is going to compare deep penetration welding between infrared and green lasers. As can be seen in this video, the weld is very consistent and spatter-free. Now with the infrared, it is very unstable, there's a lot of spatter, and the weld position varies from start to finish. The consistent absorption of the green wavelength can allow for controlled penetration of copper components. This is very important in electrical components as shown. Thank you for watching this edition of Ask the Expert. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out to the application department.